Good morning everyone, myself Sanjeev Kumar. Today in this lecture we are going to solve a simple numerical problems. Now the question is, a short shunt compound generator supplies a current of 100 amperes at 220 volts. If the shunt series and armature resistances are 50 ohms, 0.025 ohms and 0.05 ohms respectively, calculate the generated EMF and power delivered to the load. So the short shunt compound generator is given here and he is saying that it supplies a current of, supplying current means it is nothing but a load current. So it is supplying to the load. So load current 100 amperes is given at a voltage, it is nothing but load voltage 220 volts. And shunt series and armature resistances are given. You can see here shunt resistance is higher and series resistance is very low and armature resistance is a nominal value. Now calculate the generated EMF and also calculate the power generated. Now for the solution, it is better to draw the short shunt generator, then we can easily understand the current relations. Okay, so this is the basic diagram. Now V is the load voltage available, it is given how much, it is 220 volts. And also load current is given IL. So what is the value of this IL? IL is 100 amperes is given. And this is generated EMF upward direction for this RA is given. So what is the value of RA, which is equal to 0.05 ohms. And this is shunt winding. So RSH value is given, which is equal to 50 ohms. And this is series winding, the resistance is given 0.025 ohms. It is very less and compared to, and this is the node X and this is the armature current and this is shunt field current and this is series current. Now from this diagram, what the current relations we have remembered and how we are going to calculate the generated EMF. You can remember, to calculate the generated EMF, to calculate the losses, to calculate the efficiency, the armature current is the important factor we have to calculate by using shunt and load currents, load current series and shunt currents. So we have to find out the currents first, then we will go for the voltage and EMF relations. Now write the given data for this. So what is the data is given? A short shunt compound generator, a short shunt compound generator. Now load current is given, so load current IL is given, which is given by 100 amperes. And load voltage is given. So what is the load voltage? Load voltage V is equal to 220 volts. And resistances are given. We can written as shunt resistance RSH 50 ohms and armature resistance. And armature resistance RA is equal to 0.05 ohms and series field resistance or series winding resistance RSE is equal to 0.025 ohms. Now what we have to calculate? We have to calculate generated EMF and also power output. For the given problem, we have to find out generated EMF and the power output. Now observe this diagram. What we'll understand from the connection diagram, series current and load currents both are same. Okay.
read here from connection diagram IL is equal to ISE, which is equal to 100 amperes. Now series current is determined, so two currents are determined. Now what is the remaining currents? Shunt current and armature current. So armature current IA is given by, so I will get IA is equal to IL plus ISH or ISC plus ISH. You can see here by applying KCL at node X, ISH plus ISC, ISC is equal to IL. You can go for either relation IL plus ISH, since IL is known, 100 amperes. Now how we are going to determine shunt current? The shunt field current is given by ISH is equal to, so what is the shunt field current? We can have the relation between this. So what is that ISH? We can write in terms of ISH into RSH is equal to EG minus IA into RA, or else V plus ISA into RSA. Now since we don't know armature current and we don't know generated EMF, so we cannot take it, we will take into this one. So ISH into RSH is equal to V plus ISA into RSA. Now what is ISH formula? ISH is equal to V plus ISC into RSC by RSH. Now what is this ISC and RSC drop in series winding? Now we will calculate it. So drop in series winding is equal to ISC into RSC. So what is ISC? We know already ISC is 100 amperes. So 100 into series winding resistance. So what is the series winding resistance? 0.025. So what is the value of this? It will be 2.5 volts. Okay, since it is 1000 term, you will get 2.5 volts as a series winding drop. Now what is the shunt current? Substituting here, therefore ISH is equal to V, 220 plus series winding drop 2.5 divided by what is the shunt resistance? 50 ohms. Now 222.5 by 50 you may get, so what is the value of this? 4.54 amperes. Okay, now this is the value of, so 4.45, actually 4.45 amperes is the shunt current may get from this one. Now once you calculate the shunt current, you can going to determine the armature current. So how you are going to determine the armature current? So that is calculated by, now I am going to take off this given data. So ISH is equal to how much? 4.45 amperes. Therefore IA is equal to IL plus ISH, nothing but 100 plus 4.45 amperes. Now the armature current is calculated. Now once you calculate the armature current, shunt current and series and load currents will calculate the generated EMF and voltage. Okay, so the generated EMF and voltage relations in short shunt compound generator. So we know that Now I will type on this. So the relation between the voltage and EMF relations in short shunt compound generator. Short shunt compound generator is given by. So what is that relation we are having? Eg is equal to, so generated EMF having two drops. What is that? Drop in armature plus drop in series winding, which is equal to V plus Ia into Ra plus Iac into Rac plus brush contact drop. Since brush contact drop is not given in our problem, so we can neglect it. So substituting Ia, Ra, Iac and Rac, we will get the total generated EMF in this problem. So Eg is equal to, what is the V value? 220 volts plus, what is Ia value? 104.45 multiplied by Ra. What is the value of armature resistance? 0.05 plus Isc into Rsc. What is Isc? Isc is same as your load current, so it is going to be 100 into 0.025 plus 0. So since brush contact drop is not given, I substituted 0 here. So it is easy to calculate generated EMF. Now total calculation will make 227.92 volts. So this is the generated EMF in this problem. We can calculate series drop is already given 2.5, and this is the 104.4 into 5. So 5 times you may get in terms of some 5 band, so 220 plus 5 plus 227.92 volts is the actual generated EMF for this problem. Now once you calculated the generated EMF, what is the power delivered to load? So we know already the formula for power delivered to load. So the power delivered to load is nothing but voltage across load multiplied by current flowing through the load. So and written as power delivered to load is nothing but P output is given by V into IL. Can also call it as output power P is equal to P output is equal to V into IL. So what is the V value? 220 into what is IL? IL is nothing but load current, 100 amperes. Now P is equal to 22,000 watts. Now the power is measured in watts. Now P is equal to, so P output is nothing but 22 kilowatts. Now this is the solution for this problem. The generated EMF is 227.92. And output power is 22 kilowatts. So by using current relations and generated EMF and voltage relations, we can easily determine the generated EMF and power delivered to load. Now we will make one more numerical problem on DC shunt generator. So the question is, a 4-pole DC shunt generator with lap connected armature has armature and field resistances are 0.2 ohms and 50 ohms respectively. If it supplies a 6 kilowatts lamp load at 200 volts, calculate armature current, current in each parallel path and generated EMF. Now brush contact drop is 2 volts, it is directly given. So the solution can be obtained by, so better understand this formula. Since it is a shunt generator having 4 poles and lap connected, so that we will get the solution for currents in parallel paths. Since it is a lap connected, number of parallel paths equal to number of poles, and armature and field resistances are given, and lamp load and voltage is given. So what is a lamp load? It is nothing but output power. So output power is given, and output voltage is also given, nothing but load voltage. So that we can easily determine the load current, then we will calculate the armature current, then we will go for the generated EMF. So the solution is obtained by, now for some better understanding, let us draw the shunt generator. Now this is load current, it is given, sorry, load current is not given, load voltage is given. So we can written here 200 volts and P is given 6 kilowatts, and this is generated EMF going upward. RA is given. What is the value of RA? 0.2 ohms, and this is RSH, which is equal to 50 ohms. Now this is a simple diagram, connection diagram of DC shunt generator. Now you can see here the generated EMF delivers a current of IA, then this IA is dividing into load current and shunt current. So you can also remember the current relations. So load voltage is 200 volts and load power is, output power is 6 kilowatts. Now let us write the given data for this. So what is the given data? A DC shunt generator having number of poles. So number of poles P equal to 4, and it is lap connected. You can write here it is lap connected. So number of parallel paths, in lap is equal to, A is equal to P, so A is equal to 4. And armature resistance is given. So what is the armature resistance is given. So RA is equal to 0.2 ohms, and shunt winding resistance is also given. RSH is equal to how much? 50 ohms. Now output power is also given and load voltage is given. So output power P is equal to 6000 watts. Now load voltage V is equal to 200 volts. Now what is the parameters we have to calculate? We have to calculate armature current and generated EMF and a current in each parallel path. Now the solution is very easy. Since it is a DC shunt generator, we can directly calculate three current relations. So the first, we have to determine three currents: load, armature and shunt. So load current is determined by using load output power and voltage, and shunt current is calculated by voltage across shunt winding divided by shunt resistance. In shunt generator, armature current shunt generator, armature current is given by Ia is equal to IL plus ISH. This is the basic relation we have to remember. So by calculating Ia and ISH, armature current is easily determined. So let us calculate for IL, for load current calculation. So IL is equal to output power divided by load voltage, which is nothing but IL is equal to P by V. So 6000 divided by 200. Now what is IL value? IL is equal to 30 amperes. Now load current is 30 amperes, but shunt current is also calculated, then only armature current is determined. So shunt current or shunt field current is determined by ISH is equal to V by RSH. So why I am writing V by RSH? Same voltage is available across shunt field winding. Since it is a shunt generator, voltage across armature, voltage across load, and voltage across shunt field winding remains same. So ISH is equal to V by RSH. Now what is ISH? So ISH is equal to V equal to 200 divided by RSH. So what is the value of RSH? 50 ohms. Now 4 amperes. Now load current is 30 amperes and shunt current is 4 amperes. So what is the armature current formula? Load current plus shunt field current 4. So 30 plus 4. Now we will get the armature current. Now I will take off this given data. Now the armature current is given by armature current Ia is equal to IL plus ISH. So Ia is equal to 30 plus 4. So Ia is equal to 34 amperes. Now since armature current is 34 amperes, you can determine generated EMF, can also determine current in parallel paths also. Okay. Now armature current is 34 amperes. So what is the current in each parallel path? Now we will write here, since the winding is lap connected, number of parallel paths equal to number of poles. So it can also be written as A is equal to P. We know that in lap winding, number of parallel paths equal to number of poles. Suppose you are having 48 conductors, 4 poles. Now 48 conductors are divided into 4 poles, 12, 12, 12, 12. So number of parallel paths equal to number of poles. Whereas in wave winding, only 2 parallel paths are available, whatever may be the number of poles. So if you take 4 pole, 48 conductors, wave winding, so each parallel path you are having 24 conductors. Whereas in lap winding, we are having only 12 if it is a 48 conductors, armature conductors. Now number of parallel paths equal to number of poles. So what is the current in each parallel path? Okay. So I'm going to take off this. Now number of parallel paths equal to number of poles. So A is equal to P, which is equal to 4. Now A is equal to 4. So current in each parallel path, current in each parallel path is given by IA by A. That means armature current is equal to 34 divided by 4, which is equal to 8.5 amperes. Now armature current in parallel path is 8.5 amperes. Now total armature current is 34, but it is divided into 4 parallel paths, 8.5 8.5 8.5 8.5, and total you will get 34 amperes. Now the final one is generated EMF. What is the actual generated EMF in shunt generator? So the solution is given by the generated EMF and load voltage relation is given by, so Eg is equal to V plus Ia into Ra plus brush contact drop. Now you can see here the generated EMF is may not be equal to load voltage. Why? There is an internal drop, armature resistance. So if you deduct this drop, then only this voltage will be equal to this one. So it can be written as V plus IARA plus brush contact drop is equal to EG, otherwise V equal to EG minus IARA drop. Now brush contact drop is given 2 volts, you can directly substitute, and armature current is known and armature resistance is also known. We will substitute V, IA, RA and BCD so that the generated EMF is evaluated. Now EG is equal to V equal to 200 volts plus IA is 34 amperes multiplied by armature resistance is 0.2 ohms plus brush contact drop is again 2. Now 200 plus 34 into 2, so 68 by 10, 6.8 plus 2. Now the total drop is 208.8. So it is a generated EMF. Now the generated EMF is 208.8 volts. If the voltage is 200 volts, but the generated EMF is actually 208.8 volts, so 8.8 volts is going to drop in armature and in brushes. So since the brushes are carbon, so due to wear and tear, there is a drop in 2 volts in brushes and 6.8 volts in armature, since the armature current is 34. If the armature current increases, the drop is also increases, so that you have to limit the armature current to give the less drop in armature, and the generated EMF will be almost equal to the load voltages. Now this is the solution. Armature current is 34 amperes and generated EMF is 208.8, and the current in each parallel path is 8.5 amperes.